not look it, but I am.
And I'm the oldest. I came that distinctive spot, and I certainly look it.
You certainly do.
Connie's the cut-up in the family.
Always was.
Always will be. We should be quiet. Let Mr. Foster take our picture for the Providence Journal, and then we can play bridge.
We're doing just fine.
Oh, don't mind us, Mr. Foster. We get like a bunch of schoolgirls in there.
All right, now. Yes, hold the cards. Yes. Yes, good. Ready? Good. Hold it. Now, let's see if I remember. You're the youngest, Mrs. Bailey.
Yes.
And you're the oldest, Mrs. McDermitt.
Yes, I was the firstborn. Second.
Third.
Fourth, exactly 8 pounds.
Fifth.
Sixth. Seventh.
Eighth. We were all born before the turn of the century.
Oh, you didn't have to give up that information.
And if I hadn't been born, there never would have been any Octette Bridge Club.
Our parents were Mr. and Mrs. Frank Donavan.
Of Irish descent.
Catholics, of course.
God rest their souls.
God rest their souls.
Fine. Now let's see if I have the facts straight about your children.
Well, I have 2 children, a girl and a boy.
Me too, a girl and a boy.
Little Lil and little Peter.
That's right, little Peter. Isn't he small?
And you have 2 boys, Mrs. Hiller?
Yes, I do. Lawrence Jr. and Thomas.
And you have 3 children, Mrs. Monahan.
Oh, no, no. My husband and I don't have any children. When our parents passed away, my sister Mary came to live with us. And she's our big child.
Alice! Now let Mr. Foster get on track so we don't get him confused. And
I have the 3 children, Theodore, Elizabeth, and James. But their nicknames are Teddy, Betty, and Jimmy.
Connie, I have 4 boys, 3 cats, 2 canaries, and a snake. Did you know that, Mr. Foster?
I think so, Mrs. Emerson.
And I have 4 daughters, Joan, Jean, Jeanette, and Janice. My husband and I were partial to Jane.
Obviously.
Oh, excuse me, I forgot to tell you. My children's names are Kathleen and Daniel, Junior.
Oh.
I'm sorry.
It's okay.
I really am.
It's nothing to worry about.
Off the track again, Mr. Foster.
Oh, not yet, Mrs. McDermitt. I know that you are the principal of Clayton Junior High in Cranston.
Absolutely correct.
And your husband is the lawyer.
Oh, no. My husband is deceased. I'm a widow.
Connie's husband is the lawyer.
The firm of Emerson, Fraser, Masters, and Muldoon in Providence. And I'm the only one of us to marry a Protestant.
My husband, as you know, Mr. Foster, is Sheriff Conroy. My husband, Dan, is a salesman all over Rhode Island.
And my husband owns Wally's Variety Store, 99 Woodside Street.
My husband is an electrical engineer, and he's shorter than I am, but it doesn't bother either of us.
And what does your husband do, Mrs. Hiller?
Well, my husband, Larry, is a night watchman with Everett Mills. I love him very much.
Oh, isn't that nice?
And your husband is?
I'm the only sister who is unmarried. I'm Mary Margaret Donovan. I'm a bookkeeper. I work for the Eastern Water Company in Jericho, and as Alice said, I live with her and her husband Wally, my kind brother-in-law.
Who owns Wally's Variety Store at 95 Woodside Street.
Lil, who does Mr. Foster remind you of?
Who?
Doesn't he look like Buddy Johnson?
Oh, he's do.
Oh, he does.
Oh, he's a monster.
Buddy Johnson.
We did. He was so handsome.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Carpenter.
Oh, no offense, Mr. Foster.
Can we drop the subject?
Yes, please.
Whatever happened to Buddy Johnson?
He drank himself to death.
Oh, God rest his soul.
God rest his soul. Like his father.
get together every other Friday.
Twice a month.
It's joyous.
It's been grand.
And how did it come about? Whose idea was it?
All of us.
No, it was Anne. It started right here at her house.
I didn't even know how to play. Actually, it was Lil's idea. I simply got it organized.
Credit is due. Anne got it off the ground. She did.
And I persuaded Betsy and Nora and Connie to learn how to play.
Betsy was the slowest.
Oh, but now we are three of the best players.
Yes, we are.
And you meet twice a month?
Yes.
Gives us a chance to get together and visit. As children, we had one another, and we were very close-knit family.
And of course, we have some rules.
Oh, like what?
Oh, boy.
Always pick your sister for a bridge partner.
Never take a bridge game too seriously.
Oh. And never argue before, during,
or after a game.
And never once Mr. Foster has the smallest argument occurred.
Martha, may God forgive you.
And wherever the bridge games take place, we rotate from house to house. Refreshments and beverages are always served by the hostess after the card playing is complete for the evening.
Alcoholic beverages.
Oh, no. No. None of us indulge in that.
None of you.
Of course not. Our father was the head of the temperance league. And none of us smoked cigarettes either.
None of us.
Now, isn't that remarkable in 1934?
Oh, we may not smoke or drink, but believe me, there's not a saint among us.
Honey, speak for yourself.
Are you married, Mr. Foster?
Well, you're engaged.
I'm engaged, Mr. Foster. Now, right now, could you pick up the cards again, please?
Oh, here we go.
Is this the last picture you'll be taking?
Yes, it is, Mrs. Monahan.
Betsy.
All right, now, Mrs. Bailey. Mrs. Bailey.
Betsy. What? Oh, I'm sorry.
The cards?
I'm sorry.
She's out daydreaming her.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
All right, now, hold it.
Oh, thank God.
Connie.
Oh, I'm the most religious Mr. Foster. I'm sure you noticed.
No, she is not.
Mr. Foster is aware that I'm the most religious. You are aware, Mr. Foster?
Yes, I am, Mrs. Emerson.
Well, she isn't. Mary is.
Oh, that is true. All right, I can see. Mary was going to become a nun,
but she couldn't get into the habit.
Oh. May I offer you some refreshing home before you leave?
Oh, no, thank you. I have to be getting along. It's been very nice meeting all of you. And thank you very much.
We all love the Providence Journal. Now, it will be in the room for the reception a week from Sunday.
Yes, it will, Mrs. Carter.
Oh, we can hardly wait. It will be the talk of the town.
No, don't count on it. But let's hear it for Mr. Foster.
Oh. Rah! Rah! Rah!
Bye now.
You'll have to ask Betsy the answer to that question.
Or somebody.
Now, why don't you?
Joe Coughlin.
He's still tuning.
Oh, yes.
I thought he was dead.
Oh, no.
I'm so surprised. I didn't know he was still alive, let alone still tuning.
Oh, yes. Such a nice man.
Oh, too bad about his boys, though.
Oh, yes, 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 it was.
What about his boys?
Well,
Joe Jr. went to New York City, became a stick-up man, ended up in jail.
Oh, true.
And then his second boy, George, played saxophone, got involved with, now correct me if I'm wrong, Mary, got involved with dope addiction, damaged his brain, ended up in one of those places, and he was 30 years old.
One of those places what?
Joe's son is at the state institution.
True, exactly. Now, whatever happened to that shameless woman he married?
No one knows.
I liked her.
Oh, really, Nora?
Well, I did.
She deserted them before the boys were even out of knickers.
Just ran off with another man. A piano player,
oh, yes. A piano player?
Yes.
Oh, the irony.
Match ran off with us a piano player?
Oh, yes.
Rhonda Coughlin ran off with a piano player.
The irony.
Well, Joe wasn't tuning her keys properly and she wanted someone who would.
Oh.
Get this game on the road.
Well, don't try to get that.
What?
I'm thirsty.
might have something to do with it. Wouldn't you say so, Mary?
Oh, yes, definitely, Alice. Oh,
yes. S-E-X takes the blame for so much.
It's not her fault if her husband's straight.
Did anyone say it was her fault? None of us said it was her fault. None of us would we?
Could we talk about something else?
I think it's time to drop the subject, girls. I second the motion. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?
Aye.
You're outnumbered, Connie. The subject dropped. And then the man he's in enough trouble to not have to
drop. I'm not like Nanette Lavasney.
Are you starting that again?
I'm not!
No.
Bessie, in my bright honesty, all those tiny, tiny babies, what's the matter?
Bessie, she's in the bathroom.
She's in a mood tonight.
Oh, yes. I always find myself saying the wrong thing to her.
She's very upset.
Very upset?
Anne says so.
Why? Look at me, I don't know.
She's upset about Nanette Lavasney.
Bessie, hurry up. Your smart partner's got a beautiful hand.
I'm afraid she's upset about Dan.
What about Dan? Can't we freeze over before we start this darn game? Watch your language.
What about Dan? He's too handsome for his own good.
What does that mean?
It means...
Well, here she comes.
I feel better, Betsy?
I think she is.
I hope so. Now sit down, you silly goose, and let's get this game started. Little!
I'm sorry. I don't know what's gone into me tonight.
We're sorry too, Betty. We didn't mean to upset you.
I guess it's all the excitement about our photograph.
Of course.
We're excited. I mean, just think we'll soon be all famous in the geography.
I opened one heart! Finally.
Hey, those babies were so tiny when they were born, you could hold them in the palm of your hand.
One
in
spade.
The palm of your hand. It's a miracle that any of them survived.
Oh, God.
Oh,
God.
Look, do you know that the Chicago Exposition wanted the quintuplets for an exhibition, but Dr. Defoe wouldn't permit it?
Of course not.
And do you know what the hit of the Chicago Exposition is? That striptease lady, Sally Rand.
One diamond.
She uses feathers and fans.
Can you hear such a thing? Who told you such trash? Of course.
It's not trash, it's facts. It's your bid, Betsy.
Oh,
two hearts.
Pass.
Oh, just this. Won't it be a treat to see us by the paper next week? I'll bet you the third anniversary of the Octette Bridge.
Oh, it'll make Mama so happy.
And Papa, too.
Oh, the trains ever faithful, grief cannot hide him away. He is gentle, he is kind, I'll never, never find a better friend than old the train.
Pass.
I wonder if Mr. Foster guessed how many of us have false teeth.
Singing in the choir is one of the joys of my life. It makes me feel
closer to God.
Oh, yes.
Isn't it funny, little Lily is behind to carry a tune?
That's the way it is.
I can hardly carry a tune, but my Betty seems like a bird.
Oh, she does. Oh, she gets that from her father.
I suppose I have to face that.
Well, you may not sing like a bird, but your double spoon cake was delicious, wasn't it?
Mary, what's the matter?
Nothing. Are you getting that feeling again?
Mary, what is it?
I'll get some water.
She has that feeling this morning, just after her great meeting. Wally and I both thought she should go see Dr. Carroll. She wouldn't have any part of it.
It's going away.
Do you want me to call Dr. Carroll now?
No, it's going away. Just a little dizziness and something I ate last night, I'm sure.
We went up to Providence last night, Ming Chow's for dinner, and she had egg roll.
Oh,
Mary.
Not egg roll.
I know it never agrees with me, but sometimes I can't resist. I'm sure it's the egg roll.
Of course it's the egg roll. You should know better.
I know. I'm so scared, Mary.
Drink this.
Oh, Mary, Mary, Mary.
Egg roll.
I warned her.
Egg roll and a grapefruit combination.
Will you give yourself a complete examination soon? Will you do that for yourself?
I will, Nora, soon.
Dr. Carroll says that I should get more exercise.
We all should.
I walk a lot.
The egg roll.
And the grapefruit juice.
I walk everywhere. I think nothing of walking to Jericho and back.
A good night's sleep will do the trick.
Oh, it will.
Dance is good for me.
The combination of the lack of sleep
and the egg roll
and the grapefruit juice.
Dance is walking is good for my figure. Dan and I used to walk everywhere together.
Mary, can I get you a cup of tea?
No, thanks, dear. I'm fine. The water is sufficient. Thank you.
Maybe you should do more walking, Mary. You could walk with me to Jericho. We could walk together.
Not now, Betsy.
I'm just tired. Now, I think it's time we all went home anyway.
Well, bye-bye New Boulevard. It's exactly 2 minutes to 11.
Oh, and Mary will be home early tonight.
Let's go home now.
Oh, very good, Mary. We'll get you home in jig time. We have a good night.
Dan and I used to take long walks in the woods together. Why don't we do that anymore?
Because you've got two children to tend to, silly.
I'm a good mother.
Of course you are. But it's time to wend our way home.
Party's over. Back to reality, girls.
Mary does look pale. Do you think there's something really wrong with her?
It's probably just that time for her.
What time?
The change.
The change?
The change of life.
Oh, then that gives you indigestion? I thought it was hot flashes. Well, we'll know better after she sees Dr. Carroll. There's no need to worry about it now.
Nora, you're always so sensible.
Well, we get enough to worry about without inviting it. Maybe I should see Dr. Carroll, too. Why? I haven't been sleeping well lately.
Well, count pigs, that's what I do.
Pigs? I thought it was sheep.
No, pigs jumping over a fence, you know?
How do you like this hat? Sassy. Everyone says the feather suits me. Don't I look weak?
Like Sally Rand.
Who?
Feathers? Sally Rand? The Chicago Exposition. Dan?
Oh, that is wicked.
Remember now, Sunday is All Saints Day, and we're all going to the cemetery to pay our respects.
I plan to.
Me too.
So do I.
Oh, I'm sure we're all going.
Now, what time in the afternoon would be best for me?
Well, we don't all have to go together. I mean, I may not.
Mama and Papa would like it if we were all there together to pay our respects. You know how they'd love to see us together. You never need any other friends. Always remember you have one another.
It probably would be easier if we all went by ourselves.
Mama and Papa would like it if we were there together. All Saints Day was their favorite holy day of obligation.
Well, I can only speak for myself, but Larry and I promised the boys a special trip to Benson's Animal Farm before it closes for the winter.
We always go together on All Saints Day. Tradition is tradition. I'm surprised at you.
I'll go after 7 o'clock mass.
The rest of us can't go to 7 o'clock mass on Sunday in your parish. I'm sure of that. We have to get up at the crack of dawn. I, for one, have a distance to drive. Lil has
We've
a distance
made
to drive.
The plan.
Then postpone them. The boys won't mind.
Of course they will. Larry and I promised them for Halloween. And Larry was able to borrow his brother's car so we could make this special trip. Dan and I would have trouble on Sunday.
Hush, Betsy. No. I suggest you change your plans. Betsy and
I'm sorry, but Larry and the boys come first. You know that. They're alive. And Mama and Papa
are dead.
Yes, they are.
Their spirit lives on if we want it to live on.
I'm sure they'll forgive me.
I know it.
On Sunday, I will visit Mom and Papa's grave after 7 o'clock mass, and I will bring them a bunch of violets.
They always love violets. I've never heard you talk this way, you of all of us. I'm shocked.
Martha, it's all right. Nora was just...
No, it's not all right. Mama and Papa will be very sad all Saints Day.
Oh, you're making such a fuss.
And I'll make a fuss if I want to make a fuss, thank you.
Well, you are making a fuss.
And that's enough out of you. Give me that look. I don't like that look.
Well,
now. I will be in the cemetery at 3 o'clock on Sunday afternoon. How many will be there to join me? May I see a show of hands? Betsy, dear? You see, Nora? The rest of us will be at the cemetery on Sunday afternoon. And if you're not there to join us, Mama and Papa will be very disappointed. I'll say no more.
No, thanks. I'll walk.
At this hour?
It's only
ready for Halloween.
You don't really think I'm cuckoo like Nanette Lamassney, do you?
Oh, honestly, you're nothing like Nanette Lamassney. You're too sensitive.
Then why did you say that?
That was hours ago. Oh, you know I don't mean half the things I say. That devil with his little pitchfork. I love you, silly goose.
You do? You love me? I love you, too.
Are you sure I can't give you a ride home?
No, I'll hop in before I go.
Oh, Betsy, try it with Connie. It's late to be walking more by yourself.
I'll be fine. I can help you straighten up.
Practically nothing left to do.
I can help you put the card tables away. Go along, Connie.
You are a silly goose. That's what you are.
You're a silly goose.
Go sit on a tack. Good night.
Next door?
Oh, yes, Mary Lou. Is she still stuttering?
Yes, but she's improving.
Oh, good.
I am a little tired, Bessie.
Do you think I'm pretty, Ed?
Of course you're pretty.
Oh,
well, Bessie, what is it? Don't cry. Oh, do you have a handkerchief?
No, I don't have one. I did the wash yesterday, but I didn't do the whites. Only the dark.
Don't use that. It's soil.
I don't care.
And what is it? You got yourself into such a state.
I'm sorry.
Calm down. Calm down now.
I'm just so upset. I don't know how to talk about it.
Is it something very personal?
Yes. Oh, yes.
Then perhaps you should talk to Sister Margaret Teresa.
Sister Margaret Teresa? Why would I... She's a nun.
Sister Margaret Teresa is very knowledgeable.
Sister Margaret Teresa knows nothing about this.
Sister Margaret Teresa was so helpful to Mama when she was in the hospital.
Sister Margaret Teresa is wonderful with people who are dying. Or think they're dying. Dan and I, we still sleep in the same room. We're not like you and John.
Pardon?
Well, don't you sleep in separate rooms?
Well, yes, yes. Most of the time now, yes. But that is mainly because John snores so loudly. It keeps me awake.
I thought it was because of his drinking.
No, his snoring.
I still want to sleep in the same bed with Dan. Still, after 13 years of marriage. I don't care if he snores or breaks
wings.
Betsy! If he visits other women.
You're imagining things.
Probably a buxom blonde with almond-shaped eyes.
Nonsense.
I know he does. In my heart, I know it.
Don't be silly.
I want him to love me.
He loves you. We know that. He's your husband.
For me, in the dark. In the dark.
Shh.
What? Is somebody listening? The children are here at their grandmother's. Did John come in?
John will be late. They're having electric new offices at the Knights of Columbus.
Then why did you say shh? Who's listening?
I am.
Did I say something wrong? It's not wrong. I miss him touching, loving me in the dark.
Betsy, you're 37 years old.
I know my age. What's that got
and
to do?
And what? 40? These romantic moments recede.
37 isn't old.
Now you're a mother first.
I'm what?
You're a mother first, and a wife second,
and myself third.
That's the way it is. One has to
fix up. I didn't ring the bell. I just walked back in. Not backwards, but frontwards.
What did you forget?
I just had the feeling that you might need a ride home after all.
Oh, Connie, I'm so unhappy.
Betsy, I'll make you some hot tea. Some hot tea will do you good.
I don't want any tea, thank you.
Betsy, a cup of hot tea will do you the world of good. Won't it, Connie?
I don't want
It'll
any.
It'll do you good, Betsy.
Like some ginger ale.
I think
ginger ale is almost as good as hot tea, Anne.
Dan is... I think he visits other women.
Oh.
He acts as if we're not sleeping in the same bed with him anymore.
How does he do that?
What?
How does he make believe you're not there?
I'm lying still. I'm staying on his side of the bed. Almost on the edge. Sleeping on his side, facing away from him. How would you feel if David did that to you?
He can't.
He can't?
We have twin beds. Twin beds might be the solution.
What are you telling me?
Well, you sleep better with twin beds. I do. David does.
I love to snuggle up to Dan. Close. To his back.
Alice has twin beds too.
Keep them. Both of you. All of you. Did you get twin beds to punish your David because of his secretary? Dan says that... I don't want to punish Dan. I don't want to punish myself. I'm talking about love.
Here's your ginger ale.
Thank you. I don't want twin beds.
Drink up.
I'm glad you're feeling better. It's good that Connie did come back. She can give you a ride home. Don't shake your head. You're in no mood to walk in the dark tonight. Freshen up now and powder.
I'm not going home tonight. I'm staying here.
You can't.
But then I'll sleep in the den.
John sleeps in the den.
We'll stay in this chair all night long.
People don't sit in chairs all night long.
Kathleen and Danny need you.
Let Dan take care of them when he gets home. That wander, too.
You must go home. You're responsible. Little Mary Lou can.
You're not my favorite sister anymore. Connie, I'll stay with you tonight.
You can't. Oh, all the boys have 1,000 friends staying for the weekend. I could not handle 1,001.
Come on, Betsy.
Let me give you a ride home.
No, Connie, I'll walk.
You silly goose. I'll drive you home.
Come on, Betsy.
When he comes home from work now, he kisses me on the cheek. He seldom kisses me on the mouth anymore. I love your sweet mouth on me. I'm sorry if I've embarrassed you. Both of you.
I'm so glad you came back. I had no idea what to say to her.
Well, I suggested that she get twin beds.
I suggested she talk to Sister Margaret Teresa.
Oh, boy. Sister Margaret Teresa would most likely tell her to take hot baths daily.
That's not funny.
It's not meant to be. I'm sure she would.
Pray for her, Connie. We both pray St. Jude.
St. Jude. Martha's already bending his ear.
Connie, who's your favorite sister?
Connie doesn't have a favorite
yes,
sister.
Yes, I do. I have one for every day of the week.
What day am I?
Your Monday.
Oh, Blue Monday.
Oh, yes. You don't get blue. Maybe you're pensive now and then, but
us are perfect.
I am.
Oh, so
thank you. Well, shall we? What are you doing?
I just remembered.
What now?
When you were hanging my coat on the shelf, I saw this.
That's one of my best. I keep it in the front hall closet for guests.
What are you doing?
I'm making a house.
Betsy, it's a little late.
It'll be fun.
It's late. Let's go home.
Betsy, really?
Come on, Betsy.
It'll be fun. And you fix the other end, just like you used to make them with me when I was knee-high to a grasshopper.
We are middle-aged women now, you silly goose.
Well, I'm not old. I'm lucky not to be as old as you two. Oh, it's wonderful. Won't you please come with me under into my house? If you don't, I won't get a ride home with you, Connie, and if I walk into the dark black night, I might get raped.
Don't talk like that.
Or get carried off by a white slaver.
You come out of there and I'll drive you home.
If you both don't come under right now, I'll have a nervous breakdown or I'll cry and scream. Loud. The neighbors will hear, Anne.
I think Papa should have spanked you more.
Your Papa and Mama never spanked me. Martha did.
Oh, come out of there, you silly goose.
If I have a nervous breakdown, there won't be any more Octette Bridge Club.
Oh, we are as cuckoo as you are to do this.
I'm not cuckoo. You said I wasn't. Isn't it cozy?
Ridiculous.
Oh, I love it. I love it better with you two beside me. Now we'll say a prayer. You said to pray to the Blessed Virgin Mary, who's partial to blessing auburn-haired women.
Virgin Mary is partial to what?
Auburn-haired women, like me.
Who said that? Nanette Lamassney?
Oh, Natalie Gambino. Just pray. I'll be here all night.
Thank you.
just for all of you.
Oh, of course. How would you even speak to her after she killed two people in cold blood?
She's sorry.
She's
well, as you know, Roland always had a cornucopia of lady friends. But this time, I believe he was guiltless. He had just come home from the hospital from a gallbladder operation. And Lynette had apparently been herself for many years.
3 years.
3 years. But as soon as he came home from the hospital and Roland came in the door, she apparently was not herself. And she accused him of philandering.
Philandering after a gallbladder operation.
And then he called on that good old scout, Sister Margaret Teresa, who was expert in affairs of the heart.
True. False. Sister Margaret Teresa never knew beans about sex.
Let's see.
Anne suggested I go see her years ago. Well, 10 years ago, when I suspected Dan of unfaithfulness. And you know what she told me to do?
Yeah, take
off that. Exactly. But what I can't believe is how Nanette Lamassi, with her common sense, could possibly think that her husband and Sister Margaret Teresa were having intercourse.
Hey!
Well, that's what it's called, Martha.
Oh,
shit.
yes, I wonder if I'll ever have one of those.
Are you sure I can't get you a pillow?
No, this is fine. It's the way it's supposed to be. Head flat on the floor, it helps.
Did you see that other specialist?
Dr. Horwood? Same as the rest. Slip disc eccentricity will be with me for the rest of my life. Go away if it's on the corner, kill me.
It will go away. I pray for you. You know that.
We all pray for you.
Everybody prays for me, Connie.
Of course.
Aren't we lucky?
Pray?
Oh, did we win that hand?
Yes, we did.
Whoopee!
Oh, good.
We did.
June, Connie.
Oh, Abba, Abba.
We gave Nora and Alice a good skunking.
Time to change tables.
Oh, that means it's time for my resurrection.
Yeah, looks that way.
Lungs over there, and then we're dropping.
I'm over there. You're in. You're at the other table, Alice.
Connie, you're over here with me.
Oh, easy, Connie.
It's okay. Oh. The other day, I was out in my backyard hanging my corset out on the line to air out, and that little boy, Wayne, from next door came over, and he asked me why I walked like a gorilla. I told him I had back trouble.
And he said, well, his grandmother had back trouble, and she didn't walk like a gorilla.
I told his grandmother, walk like a penguin. He said he thought so, too, and then we laughed. Anyway, off he went. About an hour later, I went back to get my corset off the line, reached up, lost my balance, and toppled on my behind. I sat there. I couldn't get up.
Don't ask me why.
Like being paralyzed. I couldn't get up for the life of me. It started to drizzle. I had my corset in my hand, so I put it over my head for protection, and I shouted, help! Help! And I waited, hummed songs, prayed for my boys. The next thing you know, the corset is being lifted by Wayne's mother.
Mrs. Emerson, did you tell Wayne that his grandmother walked like a penguin?
I said, yes, I did. She said she thought that was a terrible thing to say to a boy his age. I said, well, he said that I walked like a gorilla. She said, you do. And I said, well, I walk like a gorilla because it pains me to waddle like a penguin. Now, would you please help me to my feet and hand me back my gosh darn corset?
I don't believe that story.
Do I lie?
Well, what happened? What did she do?
Well, she helped me to my feet, gave me back my corset, and told me that she forbade Wayne to ever come into my yard again.
Well, why did you say such a terrible thing about his grandmother?
Because he made me mad.
A child?
Yes, a child.
You could exercise a little self-control.
Self-control can eat you alive.
You hear that, Martha?
Am I to surmise that you are now an expert on self-control?
You may surmise that if you like.
Draw, Mary.
At least she gave you your corset back.
I wanted to hit her with it.
Well, why didn't you?
I'm a lady.
Come and draw, Betsy.
Betsy, go and draw.
I'm going, Martha.
I have told you forever and a day that I don't like that look.
Oh, good, Betsy, we're partners.
You and me, Connie. Oh, I have an idea. How about before we start the next rubber, we get down on our knees and say a prayer for our boys overseas in Europe, Far East, wherever, and especially for our own
I think that is a wonderful idea.
Isn't it?
Yes, very
good.
Oh, you don't have to get down.
I certainly will. I may end up on all fours, but God will know what I'm intending. Right, God?
Right. We'll offer this prayer, particularly for our own kind, so that they'll come home safe and sound with all their faculty. No offense.
Beth, will you just start before I call over?
We offer this prayer for our own kind, Connie's four sons.
David, Kevin, Philip, and William.
Nora's two sons.
Lawrence and Thomas, watch over them.
My boy, Teddy.
My son, Danny. May he come back from the Navy with all his faculty safe and sound, and not be ashamed that his mother was away at the Necho Hall. God bless him. God bless him.
Betsy, 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 we're not praying for ourselves.
If I want to pray for ourselves, along with my own son and all my nephews, I will. I don't think anyone in this room should object to the way that I pray.
Two hearts.
Three diamonds.
Two clubs.
Pass.
We need roots.
Pass.
People need roots.
Do not try.
Traditions.
Three hearts.
Security.
Pass.
Honor.
Pass. Martha, are you planning to run for governor?
Pass.
Three spades.
Two gold.
Trump it is.
Pass.
All I'm saying is that there's enough turmoil now with the war without changing other things, especially the national anthem.
With a dummy, Martha.
I know.
Two gold. Trump it is.
I heard you.
I'm just sorry that I wasn't home to make my boy's breakfast this morning. He left for the moon.
You don't have to feel guilty about that. It's a bit messy.
I don't feel guilty. I'm sorry. Danny loves blueberry pancakes. I would have made them.
Betsy bit.
Oh. Four spades.
Pass.
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 It's ours, Nora.
Are you comfortable over there, Mary?
Fine, Alice. Dear, fine.
You know what else I was thinking when I was sitting out there in the rain with my corset over my head? I was thinking you never read anything anymore about the D on quintuplets.
Well, that's because they're midgets.
You crazy!
Isn't this pretty? Michael gave me this when we were first married. I never wore it to purpose. Now I wear it.
It looks lovely.
Stop yelling,
Alice. I'm not yelling.
Dear, I just raised my voice.
I'm not deaf.
I did a show.
Remember now, in addition to the costumes, each of us has to do a little show for the prize. Same rules as last year.
I'm happy to go.
Nora, has Larry got used to his hearing aid?
No, he hates it. But he says it helps.
I hate mine too, but he's right. It does help. You're the dummy. Come and talk with me.
He says it reminds him that he's not 20 anymore.
You and Larry always act like good 20.
Oh, we do not. We're very dignified.
We are still lovebirds.
You do still love him?
Of course I do. I loved him from the first moment he kissed me.
On the front porch, I remember, I was behind the screen door. I reported to Mama, Mama reported to Papa.
You scolded me, told me I shouldn't let any young man kiss me. Oh, so bossy.
I was the oldest. I was trained to be bossy. There was a house full of babies to take care of.
Like me.
Like me. And after I scolded you, you told me you wanted him to kiss you for the rest of your life.
Uh-huh. And he did. And he still does.
Oh, so.
Love.
Stop it, all of you. Can I get you something, Martha? Some ginger?
No, no, Nora. Come and sit. I have your favorite beer, Canada Dry. A few years ago, I was shopping in Jericho, Christmas time, and I saw a man and a woman ahead of me, holding hands in the street. And I remember thinking, look at them, holding hands at their age, behaving like children. And then the couple stopped and turned and looked in the store window. That couple was you, Nora, you and Larry. Now, I didn't approach you. I turned and I hurried back to my car. I got in behind the wheel. I didn't move. I couldn't.
was that Nora did the best of us in the husband department.
Oh, well, thank you. I think so, too.
You didn't? I did. Oh, no, you didn't. Peter's so short.
Oh, one of us. I think Dan is the best husband right now. He's been so kind.
Oh, he has.
True. Very considerate.
Oh, yes, he is.
And Quinetta Hall, he came to visit me every day. Oh, not the first month, but the following 4 months.
And it's such a long drive back and forth.
Yes,
I appreciated his coming every day.
Shall we finish this hand?
And since I've come back from there, and with the continuing help of Dr. Chisholm, I'm beginning to learn courage. I never knew I had any, but I do.
Shall we?
And since I've come back home, I've tried to take small steps, have the courage to say what I think, and make changes. I told Dan that I would no longer iron his shirts, and he would have to take them to the laundry himself.
What did he say to that?
He said,
all right.
Oh, he did?
He did. But then he asked me why. I said, because I wanted some time to do some reading or maybe go to college.
College? At your age?
And I told Dan that I wanted to still sleep in the same bed with him. Again, we did, and we were intimate, and it was heavenly.
Heavenly is nice, Betsy.
Yes, ma'am, it is.
That's enough of that.
Let me finish, Martha. Please, it isn't easy, and I need to say it out loud. I need to let you all know that I want to change. I want to be healthy.
Well, go on. Go on. Don't let me stop you. Go on. Go on.
But sharing the same bed again doesn't remove the long-term problem. I told Dan that I would no longer put up with his shenanigans with other women, and if he couldn't halt his shenanigans, then I wanted him to live elsewhere. I wanted a separation.
What did he say to that?
Well, he looked at me as if he'd been shot, which, over the years, I'd thought a lot about doing, but I never had a gun.
But what did he say?
He said, is there any more pie? And I said, help yourself.
You didn't.
I did. I've got a lot more to say, but I can't right now. I'll try later.
What kind of pot? Have to.
Oh, she wants to.
and win.
Well, of course you do.
I am pilgrim woman. I live in a nice log cabin with my husband, pilgrim man, who is a hunter, and my nice dog Spot, who is a dog. And my nice turkeys.
And do your turkeys have names, Gilmore?
Yes. Turkey one. Turkey two. Turkey three.
Oh, turkey four. And what did you do this morning, Gilmore?
I went down to feed the turkeys, and turkey two came and pecked at my skirt.
And what did he say? Bobble, 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 bobble.
He said not to kill him. Next month at Thanksgiving, because he was dreaming of a white Christmas.
Something strange in the woods that day that really gave me a scare.
For Grandmama had creeping eyes, and Grandmama had creeping ears, all the better to see and hear, she told me. But Grandmama did bare her teeth, growl, and warned me. The wolves in Grandmama's clothing growl, who tripped me. I whacked him once, I whacked him two. I say, Grandma, I know that's true. And now the wolves are one more view for Grandma.
Doing fine.
Should we?
No. We should treat her like we've always treated her.
Well,
Pilgrim woman. Senorita from Mexico.
Oh, ole.
Red Riding Hood. Pilgrim woman. Oh, so far there's a tie.
Red Riding Hood and Pilgrim woman.
The Octette Bridge Club was something to look forward to. Safe. think I was stupid, but
no.
I had the chance here to prove that I wasn't. I became something. I could win. I became a good bridge player. My claim to fame and fortune. I don't know why I did what I did. It was a beautiful day, and I was cleaning our room. I went inside and I got dance pants and jackets, and I took them out in the backyard and had a bonfire. And when I was finished, I went back inside and I ran upstairs and I went into the bathroom and I slashed my wrist.
Don't! You weren't yourself!
Dan had to commit me. He didn't have much choice. But I wanted to go. I think I wanted to go years before. I needed help. Why didn't you come to see me? Oh, you sent gifts and cards and flowers. But not one of you came to see me. My sisters. That hurt so much.
The doctor said, Dan said, that it would be best if we didn't visit.
That was only the beginning, Nora. For the first month.
We didn't know what to do. We wanted to visit. We thought it was best. We all agreed. It was a mutual agreement. We went to Mass together for you. We prayed for your quick recovery, and our prayers were answered.
Baloney. We didn't want anyone gossiping about the wonderful Stanley Donovan girls. Oh, the scandal. Or anybody seeing us going in and out of Quidneck Hall, as if anyone would in that place won't suck it. Oh, but when Martha had her operation, we were there in full force. Mary had a stroke, we were there. Going into that place, oh, Quidneck Hall. I guess we were all frightened. More baloney. No excuses. It was pretty disgraceful. All of us.
We agreed.
Oh, I know we agreed.
It was a majority rule.
And it was wrong. I should have come to visit you. We all should have. I'm ashamed.
So am I.
Me too.
So can I.
Can you forgive us
in time?
Well, Alice has got a new bulova. Give her 30 seconds, Alice.
More time than that.
Okay. We're patient.
What I wanted to say earlier, I couldn't. I wanted to dance first and surprise you all.
You did that.
What I wanted to say was that tonight is my last night with the Octette Bridge Club.
What do you mean by that?
Tonight is my last game.
No, what? Fancy.
Is this some kind of revenge? Because we didn't come to visit you?
No, it's more than that. I get lost with all of you. I want to do my own walking.
Fuck, oh, we're a walker.
You know what I'm saying.
Betsy, won't you please change your mind?
Please, Betsy.
You're a part of us.
Please. Don't beg, baby brat.
Damn it, I'm trying to grow up.
Stop that swearing.
I'll speak as I please.
Oh, aren't you brave? You're so brave. Well, go desert us. Good riddance to bad rubbish.
Oh, that is a rotten thing to say.
You think you're the only one who suffered? I know heartbreak. I know adultery. Michael was deserting us. Leaving his family, moving out to live with a waitress, a tramp with dyed red hair. She even had the nerve to come to his wake.
None of us knew that.
Do I broadcast my pain? Did I ever? No. Not like some. No one knew. No one. Michael told me he couldn't stand living with such a self
self-righteous prude anymore. He broke my heart. I know heartbreak. Don't touch me. Don't anyone touch me. I begged him to reconsider. I got down on my knees and begged him. He agreed to stay for the rest of the week. And the next morning on his way to work, just as he was crossing Main Street, that drunken driver hit him. I don't know why I told you all that. Unless there's a lesson to be learned. Yes. Yes, there is, Betsy. Do you see what happens to deserters? God is watching.
I don't think I'm going to get hit by a car on my way home today, if there is a God. I think he's merciful.
If? You ought to have your face slapped.
And you'd be happy to do that like you did when I was a child.
You're only slapped if you misbehaved.
I always misbehaved according to yours.
You deserved it.
You go to hell.
Betsy. Martha. Stop. Betsy. Listen. Please. We are close. Eight of us. Born from the same woman, strong when we're together, and for me, it's been the joy of my life. I am so grateful for the gift of my sisters. I love you all so much. Betsy, I won't be around much longer. There, I said it out loud. Don't cry, Alice. I'm not afraid. Betsy, I'm not very demonstrative. Maybe that's what you mean about all of us. Come to me now. Come and embrace me. Hug your sisters, each of you.
Thank you.
me.
Oh, you are the exception to a law.
Nice if we could live for ever.
How about an old favorite?
Oh, good idea, Mel. I meant what I said.
Oh, I know you did, but tonight's tonight, and it's our 13th anniversary.
And 13 is an unlucky number.
Always was.